Hi everybody, this is Angel Arts, and welcome to session number 20. This is the final, this is the finale episode of the Mass Effect Season 2 Revolution campaign, and I'm feeling very bittersweet. I'm both excited, but also sad at the same time. It's so hard to believe that a year has kind of gone and went, and it's just really sad. So I hope that you guys know how much I appreciate you all in auditioning in the first place. And we've come a long way, and I feel like we formed some pretty good friendships here, and I'm really going to miss this experience. So, fittingly, I wanted today's warm up to simply be for you guys to share your favorite moment or moments, if you can keep it brief, from the campaign itself. And this can be in character moments, this can be out of character moments, it can be whatever you want. I mean, if you want me to start, I can start.
You can start, please.
I mean, I think obviously my most favorite moment is when we had the in-person session and I was able to have at least two of you in the dining room with me, and the other two were tucked away in this room. Like, this is the same room that Mikhail was in, mm-hmm. You know, with I decorated exactly the way his room looked like. Mm-hmm. So it took a lot of time to, like, pull down and
I
put
know,
back up
right?
these,
and then putting it these, back up. Oh my goodness.
Putting it all back up. So I'm glad. I hope you appreciated that, Mikhail.
I appreciate it so much. So much.
Yes. And Astro was just in your bathroom, except you took down your shower curtains to put up a green screen.
Yeah, put the green screen up on the... Yeah, so that was my favorite. There was much food to be had. And then probably my favorite in-character... I don't know, I always find the first session to be my favorite, just because everything's new and fresh, and I always enjoy exploring these characters for the very first time and finding out how they work and behave and interact with the other characters. So there's always a very special spot in my heart for session one. So that would probably be my favorite in-game moment. How about the rest of you all?
As for in character, I'd say it's a tie between the entirety of session three, because session three, man, that was something.
Can you remind the viewers about session three?
Session three was the one episode where the trivia system sun blew up, and even out of character, I remember, like, it took us the entire week to like, get over the moment, because we were like, oh my god, I can't believe this happened. And, in character, it's a really driving moment for technically all of our characters, because in a way, we all have ties. Maybe except Gimmick. We all have ties with Palavan. So I guess another one was session seven, or I think it was session seven, the Back to the Future episode. Because I absolutely love the concept of just a non-combative situation in which our roles really were important, and was incredibly stressful, but a good kind of stress. Like, this was really fun. And out of character, I mean, I'm gonna say the in-person session, because I mean, we got to meet and in person, I mean, and it was incredible. And I know that this entire campaign, we've made great friends.
Since you're on the floor, Kiwi, do you want to share with us some yeah. goodies that you've acquired?
I got some friends in the mail the other day.
Oh.
So I have Nathan and Dia.
Oh.
They're going to be shipped to their respective players in the next week.
Can you raise them up a little bit? We can only see them waist up. Oh.
Dia,
okay, turn Dia around. Let's see the rest of Dia. Let's see Dia from the back. Oh, I love that.
It's so cute.
Did Mikhail have any say on the dress? Or?
For all of you RuPaul's Drag Race fans, that's dress supposed to be like a Manila Luzon's dress from All Stars 4, when the Silver Fox one with all the glitter. Apparently, it's apparently really glittery too.
Yeah, it is glittery. Like the actual fabric has glitter in it. So, and Nathan has all his tattoos.
I see that.
And he has number 27 in the back.
I don't see the 100% Irish beef tattoo. Where is
that? Sadly, the pants are sewn on, so.
Oh.
That's a specialty gift only sort of thing, Herc.
I was going to say, you need to send that back. Send it back and say, I need this tattooed.
I share a few of my favorite moments with Kiwi and you, Herc. But for me, the standouts for... especially for first session, one of my favorite moments was how I kind of ruined my character's backstory with what I sent you when I killed my mom. So I really enjoyed that one, and also really enjoyed. I really enjoyed beating the shit out of Nathan.
I had no idea. I couldn't tell at all. I couldn't tell.
I enjoyed that because that is such a meme.
To be fair, the audience also enjoyed it too, it seemed.
Really?
The viewers seemed to enjoy that as well. So thank you, Mikey, by the way, for being such a good sport, because it seemed like it was very well received. Thank you.
I'll go rapid fire. Session zero was great fun. I liked getting to meet everyone here and seeing everyone first time and all that. That was fun. Session one, I thought, was a great introductory time for everybody. We got to see everybody's characters, got to meet everyone, got to see how everyone would gel in the future. Session three, for the same things Kiwi mentioned, I actually had to go to work after session three, and I was a ghost at work that whole day, essentially. I wasn't there. Session 7, I really enjoyed for the same reason. Session 8, I really enjoyed because we got our second quote-unquote meme in Nagi introduced to the whole session. We had Navid, we had all the shipping. The shipping I really enjoyed overall. All of Nathan's ships. There's a list of them on the Harkiverse wiki now. There was a lot of different times. I really enjoyed session 14. I felt like that was a really nice change of pace. And
which one was that again?
Session 14 was the hot springs spa episode.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So we got to unwind, relax, and we got to, you know, dive deep into our characters' thoughts and feelings, which was really fun. I really enjoyed going to DC to meet Herc, IRL. That was fun. Got to have some Korean barbecue, which I have been craving ever since I got back to Ireland, and I can't have any. So,
Korean barbecue?
You said barbecue.
Barbecue. Okay.
It's great. I really enjoyed a lot of that stuff. Out of the IRL stuff was really fun. We got to see a lot of things. Got to eat a lot of good food. And, you know, Herc looked after us. So, you know, the Harry Potter people, you know, Herc will look after you.
Visit me, please.
Do it. Because Herc made us feel it. And Astrid didn't go. He kept showing us all the food that he made.
Astrid kept editing in them into the pictures and stuff, which is really funny.
Oh, yes, that's right. I have to put I have to post the photos of Mikhail and Astra joining us.
Yeah, for dinner in our days. Yeah.
Peeking out of the corners.
Here, awesome. I'll give you one. Here, picture just for you to Photoshop into
just
it.
Just to edit in.
I think, I will try to not say anything that any other of you already said, but let's see. For me, as a player, I really liked. like the DLCs and such, like the red universe. No, I mean the blue universe. Or the, no, it was the green one, right?
The green.
Yeah. I sent all of them.
All of them.
But yeah, and the chances we had to play with other players, like the crossover and such, those were like nice.
You enjoyed those.
Yeah, I really liked it because even though it was like, it could cross over with characters from another campaign and such, I think that we still made some character development in there. And yeah, they still got to show us what happened with the characters after that time. And yeah, it was nice to meet them in person, like, you get to talk with them too. With the players, I mean. Let's see. Personally, for gimmick, I think that all the opportunities where gimmick got to fuck up would be like great character moments. Like for example, when gimmick had that thing with Koalan, or other things like that. Well, I think I have. But yeah, I think things like that, I think, were really fun and gave opportunities for him to grow up as a character.
Oh,
yeah.
Cool.
I could
thank
keep
you,
talking. Astro. Oh, yeah, and that time we met, Stan. That was nice, too. And the first session, there we go.
Yes, I enjoyed that, the Stan part as well. I was curious whether or not Stan would become a NPC party member, or if you were just going to shoot him. So I'm happy you guys didn't. I thought he was an interesting character. Cool. All right. So before I forget, Nathan has to roll something for Zadreri.
You want me to roll an athletics and a performance, or just one?
Yes, please. Let's do that.
So athletics, 28.
Nice.
Performance, 31.
Oh,
damn.
Wow.
Oh, she had a good time.
I'm just going to sit over here eating my peanuts.
So, So because of that amazing performance, I'm going to have to say that you have a... Well, let me see. Dia will have to do a performance as well. Dia, roll me, because I think Dia and Jules have to finish what they started, I remember from last session. So if you want to roll me instead of an athletics, acrobatics.
Okay.
And then I'll let you have an advantage in your performance. So roll me an acrobatics, and then roll me a... Roll me an advantage performance.
Jesus, I want to use my paragon okay. to fix that.
Okay.
I'm sorry, it's just like using my paragon points.
Go ahead and reroll. I'll let you reroll.
Thank you.
You can't use it, but you can't use it. A point for a while. But
okay,
yes.
That's fine. That's fine with me. This is worth it.
Better.
Yeah,
worth it. Now roll.
I don't mind dying
advantage.
Later.
I don't mind dying
this
later.
This is an important task.
This is.
I'm assuming that Vito will need to roll something similar as well before the final.
Yes!
Battle.
There you go.
Good. Vito, feel free to roll something,
I guess,
as well.
Can I give them like an extra d6? Like,
are you going to be observing this?
No.
Okay.
Give it into that for itself. He's very voyeuristic, apparently.
Knowing that they may need some help.
Are you giving us like theme music or something?
Hacking
into the system,
maybe.
Thing, sexy music.
And then I think that Indy will get an automatic morale boon bonus because she's gotten into a relationship with Stan. So I think that by default already gives you a morale bonus. So
honey last time.
I'm sorry?
We as a group eat the honey last time. Didn't we get
you
like
did. Yes. So what I'm going to say is because all of you had honey last time. Everyone across the board gets a plus one bonus to all of their d20 rolls. Plus one morale bonus to all their d20 rolls for the final confrontation. In addition, because of the other morale bonuses that you just rolled for, Nathan rolled very high. So I'm going to give him a plus two bonus to damage.
Oh boy.
Plus two bonus to damage.
That's a spicy one.
And then for Dia, I'm gonna give you a plus one bonus to either your d20 rolls or your damage rolls. It's up to you how you want
to. I'll get that to the damage then. Plus.
All right, so you'll get plus one to damage and plus one to your.
Okay.
Plus one to your damage and plus one to your attack rolls or d20 rolls.
Okay.
And saves and everything.
Okay, awesome.
And then same thing with Indy and Vito. You get a plus one bonus that you can apply either to the d20 rolls you already have or the damage rolls.
Okay.
To remind everybody about what the final confrontation plan is, because in a moment I'm going to ask you who you're going to try to recruit to help you, if you're going to recruit anyone else besides the people that are on your ship. Because you have met several people along the way, so if you have reasons to believe they would help you with this final confrontation, you're welcome to pitch characters.
I think we should have Stan take over the Arx guns.
And
just Stan? Jules. Okay.
And yeah, Jules with us for the PB&J.
Yeah. And maybe send Pip to the Arx as well to help with, you know, maintaining it and all that sort of stuff.
That's probably a very good idea. Pip is on the Arx, Stan is on the Arx, okay?
Yeah, I mean, Colin, what do we do with Colin?
He
we
can help,
do need bionic powers to protect the ship, because if the ship doesn't work, then...
Okay, so Koalin is going to stay on the Revolution. Okay. How about Zadrari?
She's mostly a melee.
Nathan's mostly melee, but thanks to the Angar, and his guns will shoot light energy, so he can just use his gun instead of using his hammer or whatever else. Which does about the same amount of damage either way. So, how good is Zadrari? Isn't that good with guns, right? Like, she's not exceptional with them, no?
I don't think you've ever seen Zadrari fire a gun. She's always been using her saw blade.
Yeah, I think you're right.
I'm sure she can operate one.
Just hasn't ever used one.
It's not her weapon of choice.
I mean, if we keep her aboard the Revolution, we can have. You know, we can have her stick around. We can have her use the glasses, maybe.
Okay.
We're gonna have a very limited amount of people who can go into the Upside Down, because everyone's gonna have to hold on to whoever has delirium. So,
I would say that during 3 days' time, that Jules was able to make three pairs of glasses.
Okay.
So one pair can certainly go to Zadrari. She's.
And we should probably give Koalin the other pair of glasses, right? Because he has biotics too, and he can use those, and then we have Dia with delirium, and whoever needs to, we can have Jules hang on to Dia to be able to see things. So he can just use his rifle in that case.
What about, because Vito and Gimmick, they have to see too.
Well, Gimmick can't use the Lyrium either way. He can't hold on to the.
So he needs one of those glasses. They need one of those glasses.
If you just point where to shoot, Vito should be good.
Yeah, Vito can hang on to Dia as well. You know, we can just have, you know, two people holding on to Dia, and then you give a pair of glasses to, I guess it would be Indy's body, assuming the glasses work with her body.
Hmm.
She's used them before.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And
it's like a filter of light.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's fair.
So, we're gonna go with that then?
Do we, get the guess?
Yeah, can we call up Nilu or Salo?
So, you're going to try to call up... Yeah, you're gonna contact the guess.
Yeah.
I am assuming that based on your interactions with them prior, it's I think that Sala will have zero problem sending Geth into this. So you have a small fleet of Geth to help you. But remember that those Geth are all electronic. So you are going to need more biotic power to be able to get them close enough to this mass. Do so you look... will need more than just Kowalin and Nathan and Dia.
Can we call on Aya and like her friends to see if they can send anyone here with like any biotic power?
People from the academy, maybe?
Yeah. You can. I know that it depends on who contacts Aya. I think Aya likes certain of you more than others. So it depends who's trying to recruit, who's doing the recruiting.
Let's just not give the phone to Nathan here. no offense, but...
Maybe the, strange thing to hear, actually. Don't give the phone to Nathan, someone doesn't like him.
It's the only person in the galaxy that doesn't like him.
Okay, I'm gonna call up.
So Aya. You're going to try to recruit Aya, and I'm sure Aya probably has mercenary, you know, has mercenaries who are biotic.
Could also get Jack.
Was Vetra biotic?
Vetra, no. She's a sentinel.
Vetra's a sentinel.
No, sorry.
Sentinels are biotic.
She's some sort of, they don't get a class in Andromeda.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, she's some weird combination of engineer and soldier, essentially.
Okay, so Aya's mercenary group is TBD.
Until
we get I'm gonna have whoever is we're gonna recruit roll me a persuasion.
Okay.
So if you want to roll for that.
Yeah. Persuasion. Okay.
Nathan.
28. Okay. Oh yes.
Critical.
You have advantage, John. You have advantage on, so that's not actually natural 20.
After we do it then.
It's a 22.
Okay.
That's good enough. That is good enough. Okay. So you got Aya's mercenary group. Who else? Anyone else that you remember you befriended along the line that might be able to help you?
Can we call up Barkara and ask her if she has anyone else? Like, you know, maybe a few biotic Krogan.
I'm going to.
Who's going to ask her? Who's going to try to recruit?
I'd say we should ask Vito too. She seems to like.
Are you sure about that?
If you're comfortable with it, Nathan will do it.
We should all roll this, okay?
I mean,
geez. Well, one of you has to be the leader. One of you have. You guys can assist, but one of you has to lead.
I'm gonna try persuasion.
Remember to add your bonuses to this.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Is that with or without your bonus?
Okay.
Plus two, that's
20 total.
20. That will be enough.
Okay. I'm going to call on the Shadow Council to see if they have any contacts that we can utilize.
Oh, my.
Oh, my.
And especially considering Liara is someone who's saved this galaxy before. She probably doesn't want it to die.
Hey, do you have some tips about saving the galaxy?
Not just tips, but anyone who will come help us.
Liara just pulls out some duct tape, like, God damn it again.
Roll. Dia, go ahead and roll a persuasion. Take advantage on it, please.
Okay, advantage. 27.
Okay.
28.
All right. Anyone else?
I feel like calling Jack and asking her if she has any students who she'd like to lend to this would be a bad idea.
From the Grissom Academy, you don't want to ask Jack and her Grissom Candy students?
Okay. I mean, Nathan's going to give it to the group and say, look, if we call her up and ask her, she's probably not going to say yes because she doesn't want her students getting hurt and they could possibly get hurt. So,
talk to her?
No. I'll call her. But do you guys think I should? You think it's a fair chat? It's a risk we should take.
Yes.
Okay. Then. I will call Jack and ask her if she has any students she'd like. If she knows anybody in any of her circles who could help us out.
Persuasion.
Persuasion. That's 18, so that's 19 total.
I would say that Jack would not be interested in sending any of her students, But heck yeah, she's gonna do it herself, personally.
Oh yeah.
Personally, she would.
And she's like, a biotic, right?
Yeah. Oh, she's very biotic.
Oh, but she's coming with us.
She's super biotic.
She's one of the strongest biotics in the galaxy. Now that Lund's dead, she might very well be the strongest biotic in the galaxy.
Okay. Good Jack, guys.
And I want to call up my bro.
You should call your other dad.
Not after how the last conversation.
No, the other dad.
Oh, the other dad?
Area. But I doubt that would work. Just wow. Like, hey, we've never talked before.
Actually, you know what? I'll do it.
Oh, God.
Dia, roll with a disadvantage, please.
Okay, I want to use a renegade point for this.
All right. And roll with just a regular roll without an advantage or disadvantage.
Can I give me banners? I don't remember the name of the spell, but...
You already used a point.
Oh yeah, that's right.
You already used a point. You can't use it again for a while. You're going to have to roll with a disadvantage.
Could I assist in that?
I have a spell, flat inspiration, something like that.
You can roll an assist for that. Go ahead.
Persuasion, yes.
Yeah.
That's a nat 20.
Okay, add a plus 2 then, Mikhail, to your
I'm gonna have to add that after the roll. Okay.
So. After the disadvantage roll, yes.
Okay, so I'm gonna roll persuasion. Is it disadvantage? Yes, okay. Ooh, 12.
That's not gonna be enough.
Who are you?
That's not gonna be enough.
Okay. I wasted a natural 20 on you. How dare you?
You should have done it.
Who else? Anyone else? Or is that it? Do you want Koalan to try to get the Justicar?
Yeah, I'll assist him if he wants.
17. Whoa.
It's a much lower roll.
That's not going to be enough. Unfortunately, even with your assistance. Had the group decided to delve in more with Koalan and his matters with Justicar, then yes. But I don't think we ever got to that. Mm-hmm. So that never became a thing, unfortunately. So no.
Okay. I'm going to call up Binary Helix, specifically my brother. And yes. I'm going to ask him, can you help out at all with this?
He can help out. The best place for him, after talking to him, is him and he can help out on the Ark. And Sarah can help out keeping the portal open.
Okay.
So that's if you want Sarah and Alan. And you can have either or both, or neither.
Dia will say yes to both.
Okay. So Sarah is going to be on the Ark, helping to keep the gate open. Alan will be on the Ark as well, which will help with the overall systems while it's maneuvering around.
Actually, here's a question. Could Dia call up Vetra? Because we know Vetra is really good with guns. Could she help in the Ark?
Well, I thought Vetra was working for Aya, wasn't she?
Yeah. Doesn't mean you can't just call her and be like, hey, do you mind?
Oh, okay, true.
Because we've already gotten Aya's help. So you can say, hey, can we also have...
Once you have Aya's help, you can put Vetra on the guns.
Okay, there we go.
Cool. Is that it?
That's all I can think of.
Called Charlie Rana.
We've never met him. Wait.
No?
You mean Chris?
Where would you put him? If you did.
I mean, he's an engineer. Right? I mean, he was good at crafting things.
Just gonna MacGyver the endurance. Not the endurance, the revolution.
Okay. You want to put Chris on the Ark?
Yeah.
So there's this part in the video game screen that says, these are the characters you've chosen to put here. Are you sure? Keep in mind that if you put people on the Revolution, or if you put people backing up the Geth, or if you put people backing up on the Ark, if any of those things blow up, everyone inside them blows up with it. Just to let you guys know.
Shit.
So, are you sure this is where you want to put everybody? If you want to move people in or out, now's the time.
Where was Pip?
Pip is on the Ark.
Yeah.
And my brother.
Pip is on the Ark. Stan is on the Ark. Vetra's on the Ark. Sarah's on the Ark. Chris is on the Ark.
Like three family members on the Ark, essentially. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, basically.
Kowalin is with you, Jules is with you, Zadrari is with you, the Geth are there, Aya's group, Arkara's group, and the Shadows group, plus Jack, they basically are effectively protecting the Geth. These are all biotics. Arkara's sending all our biotics, the Shadow Council's sending their biotics, Aya's group is sending their biotics, and then you have Jack.
We have one issue. How do we defend against the telepathy? I know we have all the Geth.
That's the Geth. The Geth will.
That's all Jules. You need to get Jules onto the rock.
Okay.
Jules on the Geth eventually. Well, essentially.
And the plan was Jules has to insert the damn thing into the there.
Well, shoot it.
Yeah, shoot it.
He's got a sniper rifle. So.
Yeah, you have to get him within a mile.
Okay, that's.
And you have to make sure that, but you don't know what the activity is like there, so you might have to. Keep things from distracting him, and by distracting him I mean attacking him, so
possibly killing him and so on and so forth,
because if he doesn't make the shot or if he doesn't have a chance to set up for his shot, then some yeah, we'll see what happens.
I would rather let's okay,
this is going to be a very interesting conversation for Nathan and Jack to have later,
so yeah.
Okay, you guys ready to confirm?
Let's do this shit.
We all
confirm.
We all click confirm at the exact same time.
Confirm.
All right.
There we go.
If there is anything you guys want to roleplay the day of the final confrontation, now is the time.
Nathan wants to talk to Sarah and Jack. With Sarah and Jack, if that's okay. Not together, you know, or together, whichever one works out for everybody.
We'll say, to make things easier, we'll say that you're on the Ark. We'll say that you're meeting up on the Ark to gather everybody so that everyone's, like, formed their plan. And we'll say that Jack and Sarah happen to be in the room, and Jack goes over, gives you a punch, firm. It's mini biotic punch on the arm. And she says, Callahan, looks like you got yourself in some deep stuff that I have to pull you out of.
As always, Jack and Nathan will give her a hug.
Okay. She gives you a little bit of pat. Jack's not a huge hugging person when she's about to go fight something.
It's going to be fun, though. Just like old times.
Sort of got sick and tired of the old times, but one more, I guess, and one more feather in my cap isn't going to necessarily kill me.
Well, I will hope not.
Sarah just nods. She doesn't say anything, but she just kind of nods and agrees.
So, Jack, I'd like you to meet somebody. This is my sister. Sarah.
You have a sister?
Surprise to me, too.
She will sort of smile and says, it's an honor to meet you, Jack. I definitely admire everything that you've done, not only for the galaxy, but also for the schools. Yeah. I know. Thanks. She's looking at her uniform. You're with Binary Helix? Not a big fan of scientists. Sarah sort of says, I understand.
Well, yeah, it was a very interesting development in my case to discover this information about having a sister. But, you know, I'm still here.
Good luck, then. You're the one that's going to have to go down and dirty, though, Callahan. So don't mess this up.
He pulls out his shotgun. He's just like, don't worry, Jack. You taught me well.
Let's hope. And she's going to head out if there's nothing else.
It took Mech the whole campaign to realize that Jack was Jack from the trilogy.
Yes, what? That Jack. Yes.
The whole campaign, man.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm so sorry.
Are you sure you don't want to stick with Javi with the guns on the arc? Are you sure?
I mean, she could probably have a couple of guns at the same time, but I would rather not.
All right. You sure don't want me to put a Javi in the arc? Are you sure?
Having listened to the Annihilation audiobook, I say that's a no for me, Captain.
Oh, right.
Yeah, I think Vito would, I guess, write one last letter.
Well, Gimmick would knock up the door while you're trying to write.
Vito would just, like, hide the paper somewhere. He actually writes on paper because it's prettier, but... Yes?
Vito, are you doing something important?
Not particularly. I was getting ready.
Well, I wanted to talk something with you. Do you mind if I go in?
Of course.
And he's going to, like, open the door.
So... Well, I just wanted to ask, are you sure that you want to come with us?
Yes, this is... I doubt there would be anyone else to do this, wouldn't there?
That's a fair point. I think that at this point, you well, you have to see this through, right?
I thought exactly. I don't think I could just sit home and wait for you guys to be done. I would be afraid things would go wrong. If I'm here, I know I can help make it easier.
No one can do things better than yourself, you mean?
I'm not saying that, but...
I'm saying it.
I do have my talents.
So, I know that you want to come with us, and I understand it, because I also want to go. But, well, I think that maybe after seeing you with your family and all that, I know that you like to write things. But you have them right there, right now. I think that you should talk with them directly. Maybe, I don't know, say anything you want to say. And they can answer it to you. It's better than just writing.
I realize I write better than I talk. When it comes to academic subjects, the words just flow, but when it comes to talking about, I guess, worries and fear, good luck.
Well, there are things that you can't do when you're writing. For example, you can't sing a lullaby to something you love.
I don't know many lullabies. I could try. Just in case I don't come back.
Just clear your mind. Just in case, nothing bad is going to happen. We are going to do our best, and that's all it's needed. But yeah.
Yeah. And we do the hug gimmick. And I would assume that Solark and Ojavi are probably not there right now, because it's kind of like the last day, so he would call them instead.
Yeah. You'll call up. He'll pick up the phone. Hey, honey.
Hey, Sol.
Today's a big day.
Yeah. I think I wanted to hear your voice.
Well, I'm here. You know that.
Yeah, I do. I'll be back. You know that.
I know. And Ojavi's very excited to see you again.
Very excited to come back home.
I'm sure there'll be lots of stories.
Ugh.
I'm sure that we'll have lots of things to talk about with the movie rights and all.
I'm glad you haven't forgotten about that.
One of these days, we'll be able to make a poster to give to Nathan. He can hang something up in his bedroom for a change.
You know, I wouldn't say no to that. I think I should learn how to sing lullabies.
It's never too late.
I know one, but it's not really a lullaby. An old earth classical song my uncle used to sing to me. To hum. Something relaxing about it.
That was very nice.
I'll be home, be able to hum that to her myself.
I know she would love that.
I think I'll be done adventuring for a whole lifetime after that. Maybe I could stay and work at the museum with you. I think I'm getting a little tired.
Well, you know we're there with you, right?
Every step of the way.
Just keep fighting, and in our way, we will be here too.
I love you, Sol.
I love you too, Vito. Can we do one more dance? You'll start hearing in the background Unchained Melody. In the background.
Oh.
And you'll start doing your, like, final... You'll start dancing to that tune. There seems to be a sudden, like, rumble around the ship. And if you roll a perception roll, Vito, you'll see glints of something in the air in front of you. If you start looking closer, very closer to those little glints, you kind of see very subtly. It almost like appears and then disappears as soon as you see it. It almost looks like cracks, like cracks in the air.
So I'll call you back.
Soul doesn't respond.
Lyric?
There's no response.
Is it like staticky or?
It's staticky. The music abruptly stopped at the same time that it got all staticky.
I guess Vito would go see Jules, maybe get a pair of glasses or.
I think there's weird activity in my room right now. I just want to see what's going on.
Yes, of course. He hands you a pair.
So he was going to go back to where he was and put the glasses on.
You put the glasses back on and you can now clearly, it doesn't go in and out, you can start clearly seeing what you perceive to be cracks or slight tears in the fabric of reality itself. That's what you interpret that to be.
Okay.
You're not really sure if it's isolated just in that spot or if it's more widespread.
Oh. He's just going to check if the intercoms of the ship work or if.
Yeah, they still work.
Yeah.
Guys?
People can hear Rito's voice in the intercom.
I think we're in a race against time right now.
What is Dia doing, meanwhile?
Before
this happens or while this is happening? I'm just curious.
I think Dia is probably, like, in her room, getting her best-looking battle outfit on to keep in theme with the whole shadow thing. She's gonna have something black on her... white as ship body, and it was like putting on makeup before she decides to like call up Alan.
Can't save the world if you're not pretty.
Exactly.
Alan picks up. Alan Wintry here.
Hey.
Hey, Logan.
Hi.
You look like you're in high spirits.
Little bit. Where are you at right now?
I'm on the Ark. It's amazing. Well, you already know. You've been there yourself. Mm-hmm. I have so many questions, but unfortunately, that's going to have to wait, as we all know. Mm-hmm. But the Ungarans here have been really nice. They definitely didn't need to, all things considered, but... the plan seems crazy, but in theory, it could work.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Alan.
Yeah.
Regardless of how this goes, either way, if it ends up with everyone on that homeworld dying, if it looks like the Ark is in danger, please, please, can you leave?
Even if it means that if we do, it means we have to resort to Plan B? You know what Plan B is, Dia.
I do. I'm hoping this, like, goes okay. like, obviously there's going to be, like, a hiccup somewhere, but just like, if it looks like the ship is going to go down and is in the process of going down, please can you get to the escape pods? Or whatever the fucking Lingarans have.
The whole system will go supernova. The only way we can escape that is if the ship goes into light speed and we take the whole ship out there. Escape pods aren't going to help.
Shit.
So we either abandon the mission entirely or we stay and hold it for as long as we can.
Can you please not die?
Is that what you want me to do? Save myself? If it comes down to it?
No, I really don't want you to die.
I know. You know me. My gut reaction would be to stay.
I know.
But Logan, if you want me to leave, then you tell me that you want me to leave, and I'll do it.
Rational brain here is saying no. Emotional part is saying yes, please leave, but I can't ask you to leave right now. Maybe if I end up calling you again later, I'll say please leave, but until then, I don't know.
I'll tell you what, I'll do whatever my gut tells me to do at the moment. But if you call me up and tell me to retreat, I'll tell them to retreat.
Okay. Also, same goes if I were to die.
Yeah. I think that's very fair.
My Marc Jacobs lipstick is not to be touched.
I think it looks much better on you than it does on me anyway.
Mm-hmm. You're too mannish to wear makeup, sorry.
Well, that and I also am a fan of orange and purple, and you never were.
Yeah, well, good luck. Stay safe.
Good luck to you. I love you, bro.
I love you too. Bye, you smart little shitbag. And Chloe closes the call.
Roll a perception roll, please, Dia. And this time, roll an advantage.
Okay. Perception, where are you? Okay, there we go. Oh, good at all.
Okay. Yeah, Dia, when you hang up with Alan, there's going to be a rumble on the ship. And you also will see more clearly. It's faint, because, like, if you don't pay attention too much, you'll absolutely miss it. You can see, like, little tears or cracks in the air.
Oh, shit. Guys, we got a fucking problem.
Moments before we go, Gimme would call the main squad to the... I mean, if there are another ship or something like that, he will still call them so they are, like, connected via a communication or something.
Yes, you can do that.
So I called you all before we head into the salvation of all the galaxy. I'm kind of nervous, but I just wanted to say that since I came to life, mostly, I've been with all of you, and all of you made me what I am, and that whatever the fate holds for us, I'll be happy to be at all of your sides, and I'll do my best so things go as they should. I've been doing some investigation, and I know that Shepard made some inspiring speeches before battle. because he was the commander and all that. Do we have some sort of leader in our group? Yeah, Nathan is kind of our de facto leader, but Dia, Vito, and Nathan, do you all want to make a speech together?
Speeches aren't really my thing. Well, they are, but...
Not making them.
Not like that.
We are leading a lot of people to their possible death.
Okay. Look at me, you can broadcast this. Don't fuck it up.
We are not going to...
There's your speech.
Well, simple and effective. I was going to make one, but I don't think I could top that, so...
Let's not die. That's the plan so far.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes you need to move them, to say something that touch them in a way that makes them keep their all, even when they are at the limit.
I've done that before. Different context, but, you know.
Well, just tell them that Nathan is going to pay off all their mortgages and debt.
I would say do it for... your families, your children, future generations, for them to actually have a world to live in. Because if we don't do anything today, this is gonna be it. The entire fabric of reality is going to break apart. It's already happening right now.
Well,
it's up to us to make a difference.
I guess I might as well throw something together. I can think of something.
I think my speech works really fine, so...
So where does Nathan need to make this speech? Where will he gather people up for his speech? Or is there like just a hangar bay or whatever?
You can address the entire fleet from the cockpit.
All right, I guess he's going to walk up to the cockpit, give his shoulders a quick roll and loosen up a bit. Press the broadcast all. This is the revolution to all ships. Can you read me?
Affirmative. Continue, please.
I know this wasn't what all of you expected when you woke up this morning. And I know it's a late call for some of you, but thank you for being here. Thank you for being here to help us save not only our reality, but all realities. While the galaxy may never know about what you do here today, we will know. You will all be heroes. You will all be somebody's dreamer's light, constantly blazing in the sky like a new star. I always felt most invincible while first walking into a fight. So, I hope you all are ready. It's gonna be one hell of a fight. Revolution out.